So welcome to yet another lesson in repairing arcade PCB boards. This lesson I'm going to focus on one of the four important steps, which is make sure your power is good, make sure your reset circuit's good, and make sure your RAM is good, and make sure your ROM is good. I was working on this Missile Command board, which you may have recognized from another episode, and during working on it, something failed. And one of the problems that we are that I've mentioned, specifically the reset circuit, stopped working. And I thought this was a great opportunity to go ahead and to show you how to troubleshoot that. So let's do that. So I'm going to skip with the power check because we know the power check is good. And step two in my four-step process of fixing arcade games is check the reset circuit. So what do? Hook our oscilloscope up, probe, or you can use a logic probe. I don't have a logic probe. I sold it because once you get an oscilloscope, there's really no reason to have a logic probe anymore. I mean, they're only like 20 bucks, so it doesn't hurt, but if you have an oscilloscope, you'll never use a logic probe. You always use your oscilloscope because it's so much, it does everything a logic probe does, but so much more. So now we got to go ahead and put this on the reset pin, which is 40. And you notice here, what do you see on the display? That's low, okay? That is logic low, because low is that right there, right? As opposed to logic high, which would be that, okay? So that's a problem. Your reset circuit should never be stuck low. It should always be either high if the game is working and not resetting, or if the game is resetting and the reset circuit is fine, it should be going transitioning back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Okay, this is a problem. So we're going to troubleshoot that. And to troubleshoot that, we have to look at the schematics of the board. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's look at this circuit, the reset circuit. And it's pretty simple, so this is something we can troubleshoot easily. Let's remember, normally the reset circuit, when the game is working, this pin, 40, will always be high. If the game is working correctly, it will not be resetting, and it's not resetting if the pin is always high. If the game is not working, what the normal operation is, like if memory is broken or ROMs are broken, normally the watchdog, every so often, this is the watchdog circuit here, will be resetting this pin by pulling it low. So, but it will not be stuck low. It will go low and high and low and high and transition back and forth at regular intervals. It should never be stuck low. There's no reason it should ever be stuck low unless something's wrong in this part of the circuit where, like, this is a switch. If the switch is physically stuck, then it might be stuck low if you're pressing it. But that's usually never happened. You're very rarely going to have a problem. I once had a problem where the switch got some, like, coke in it or something, and it literally was stuck down low. But that's normally not going to happen. So anyway, we can test this circuit very easily with various tools. We can use a HP logic comparator, we can use oscilloscopes, or we can use a logic probe. So first of all, my situation that I'm seeing is this is stuck low, which is definitely not normal. So what we do is we work back. We see a pin 40, it's stuck low, and then make sure that it's actually stuck low on the part of the signal that generates it, which is pin 6 on D3. Because there might be a break in here, in the line, and that maybe it's actually everything's working, but there's a break and causing, you know, the signal's not getting through. But if everything is no breaks in that wire, that unlikely, then pin 6 should be, if it's stuck low, this will be low, and then pin 5 is going to be the exact opposite, because this is basically an inverter, a not gate, basically at D3. Pin 6 is the opposite of what the input of pin 5 is. So if we have our HP logic comparator, we just press it down there and put it in and see if pin 6 is either blinking red or stuck red. If it is, then this chip is probably bad. If you have an oscilloscope, which I'm going to show you how to use in this example also, just put both ends of the probe on, or put both probes on each side. So one probe side will go to pin 6 and one probe side will go to pin 5. And the signal should be literally the opposite of each other at all times. If it's not, then this chip is not working. You should replace it. If this chip is working fine, which it probably will be because that's pretty simple, but sometimes they break, then we go back to this chip, pin C3, which is labeled, looks like an AND gate. it is labeled incorrectly. This should be an OR gate. This is an LS32, which is an OR gate. This symbol is actually the symbol of an AND gate. So whoever made this drawing drew it wrong. But so keep that in mind, because I got confused when I was looking at this. I'm like, this is not right. This is a when I'm was troubleshooting. I'm like, these signals are not what they should be. Anyway, so for this thing to be stuck low, this will be low. That means the input at pin 5 will be high, which means the output of C3 will be high. Okay, and on an OR gate, the output 3 will be high whenever either 1 or 2 is high. Either of them is high, and the output 3 will be high. Now, let's look down here. This is a simple circuit. This is the reset circuit. Unless your switch is pressed down, stuck down, like physically, this will always be low. Okay? This will always be low because the switch, until it's pressed down, will be in a low condition. This goes to, I'm sorry, a high condition, which goes to an inverter, which makes it low. That very rarely will break unless your switch is physically, you know, stuck in, like got some glue or a Coke in it, dried Coke, or it's possible this chip D3 goes bad. But that should be always stuck at the low. I'm sorry, the low signal. So then we need to look back at this pin 1. So we know pin 2 is probably going to be stuck low. Pin 1 is probably going to be normally when the game is working, this will be actually low. When the game, if everything is working fine, when the game is not working, this will be going up and down every few seconds. And if something is wrong with this part of the circuit, this will be stuck high to get the low output over here. But we just want to make sure that the outputs match. So we can use our logic comparator to test this chip, or we can use an oscilloscope. We know pin 3 is always, if we measure that this is always high, then put a probe on each of these, pin 1 and 2. Pin 2 is going to be low, we know that. Pin 1 should be going up and down. If it is going up and down, but pin 3 is still stuck in the high condition, then this chip is bad. And if we were looking at the HP logic comparator, we would see pin 3 is blinking or stuck red. If this pin is transitioning, and this pin is low, and this pin is transitioning, everything is fine. If this pin is stuck high, and this pin is stuck high, pin 3, then we know this chip is still okay because it's doing the right logic. Then we need to go further back in here and start troubleshooting that area. Okay? So let's take a look. Let's start analyzing and seeing how far we get. Again, we're going to start here, go to here, we're going to go to here, and then test these, and then we may have to go back further in the circuit if everything looks good at this point. So we looked at the board, the schematics, I'm sorry, and we determined how to troubleshoot this. So the first step was to make sure pin 40 is low. And it is, and that's bad. Okay, but we expected that. Now let's trace that pin 40. We want to figure out where in the circuit this is happening. That traces back to D3 pin 6. And I'm going to have to turn my light on, I think, here. D3 pin 6, where do we got that? D3 pin 6, there it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we see that's low, as we expect it to be. Okay, so I just did a quick thing. To make it easier, I turned the light off and use this little spotlight thing here. So hopefully this will make things easier. So D3, pin 6. And that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we see that is low. Which we'd expect. Let's see pin 5. That is high, which we expect. So this part of the circuit's probably working correctly. But let's take out our HP logic comparator. Let's put in the chip for the LS14, 47 LS14, which is this is. And let's just go ahead and test it. Turn it off. You gotta make sure this is clean. That looks clean, so I'm gonna go ahead and just put it on. If not, use a wire brush, brass brush preferably. And turn it on. And it is working. See, the on is a red and nothing else is red. So that means looks good. And it is good. So let's move back in the circuit. Next we go to C3. And we discuss that C3, the output is on pin 3. And that is high. Right? And it's not supposed to always be high. It's supposed to always be low or switching high and low. And that's high. But is it C3 that's a problem or something that's feeding C3? So I mentioned that C3 pin number 2 should always be low because it only goes high when you press on the reset switch, the physical reset switch, which is right there. And look at that, it's high. So that is clearly a problem. That's not what I expected. I usually don't see that a switch being a problem or the one chip in front of the switch. But let's just see what happened there. It looked like it was stuck. So now it is low, and it should be. So, and our reset switch, or the reset pin, is now high, which is expected because the game is not resetting. So I actually did not expect that. I expected the chip at C3 to be bad, or the chip at D4 to be bad. Now, usually the D4 chip would be bad because those counters go bad a lot. But see what happens. I said that usually, I only seen that like once before when there was some coke on that switch, but it looks like that happened again. And I can kind of see that here. I see some corrosion on the board near the chip, so it's very possible that that chip is just kind of stuck there. And like I think it's doing it again. Yeah, it's doing it again. So it really got to just, I might have to just remove that chip altogether or replace it because it seems to be getting stuck, physically stuck. So that was a lot easier than I thought it was going to be. I thought we're going to have to go back and look at the OR gate or potentially the circuit, the chip at D4, and troubleshoot that. But there you go. So always test everything, because I almost didn't test that because I just assumed that would be fine. All right, thanks for watching.
If you like this video, please consider supporting us on Patreon at www.patreon.com/arcades. Your support helps us make more videos. Thanks. Also, please hit that like button.